लेट्स से यू आर इन्वेस्टिगेटिंग अ पेशेंट एंड यू ऑर्डर हेपेटाइटिस सेरोलॉजी बी सेरोलॉजी एंड हिज रिपोर्ट केम बैक लाइक दिस दिस इज नेगेटिव एन टी एच बी एस इज नेगेटिव एन टी एच बी सी एन टी एच बी सी टोटल इज पॉजिटिव एच बी ई एंटीजन इज नेगेटिव एन टी एच बी ई इज नेगेटिव So what do you think by seeing this report? His anti-HBC total is positive. So does he have chronic hepatitis or active hepatitis or is it resolved? What is your interpretation here? This patient has isolated elevation of anti-HBC or total core antibody. And what I interpret is, I am telling you now, so there are only three situations in which anti-HBC is seen. One is during the window period of acute hepatitis virus infections, when HBS antigen has fallen, but anti-HBC has not yet risen. So there is some gap in which there is neither HBS, neither anti-HBC yes undetectable level, and during that time anti-HBC can be detectable. Okay, and patient may be symptomatic with history of recent exposure, but about 70% have subclinical hepatitis. Okay, and in this case IgM anti-HBC is elevated, or let's say positive, and liver enzymes are elevated. Okay, so this is one scenario. Another scenario can be years after recovery from acute hepatitis B virus infection, once anti-HBs has went off. So years after recovery from acute hepatitis B virus infection, acute hepatitis, once anti-HBs has went off. Okay, in this case liver enzymes are normal and IgM anti-HBC is negative. Okay, and third condition can be after many years of chronic hepatitis B infections, when HBs antigen has fallen to undetectable level and liver enzymes not I'm telling you that after many years of chronic hepatitis B virus infection, when HBs antigen has fallen to undetectable level and patient may have evidence of chronic liver disease and HBV DNA is undetectable and IgM anti-HBC is also negative, so there are three conditions in which we can see anti-HBC. And once a patient with anti-HBC has been identified, this HBV serology should be repeated. Why should we repeat? To ensure that it is not false positive result. If there are no changes in the results, repeat results, then we order an IgM anti-HBC, okay, and liver function test to check whether it is acute infection or not. As elevated in transaminase suggest acute active infections, and if liver enzymes are abnormal with negative IgM anti-HBC, or if there is evidence of chronic liver disease, okay, then HBV DNA should be obtained to evaluate for chronic hepatitis B virus infections. Okay, so patients with isolated elevation of anti-HBC should have hepatitis B serology repeated, okay, to rule out false positive result, followed by measurement of IgM anti-HBC and liver function test to determine acuity of infections. IgM anti-HBC may be the only diagnostic marker of acute hepatitis B infections during the window period. Okay.